Now, why do I bring up Seth Rollins? So, of course, as I previously mentioned, Miz brought up Seth Rollins. So, Ambrose comes out. He double legs the Miz. He attacks Miz. The Miz Taraj are all over Dean Ambrose. And then Seth Rollins comes out. And he saves Dean Ambrose and just gets rid of the Miz Taraj altogether. They all clear house. And then we get a backstage segment with Dean Ambrose asking him what the hell that was. Rollins explains his side of the story, that he's got to get Miz to shut up about throwing his name out there and stuff like that. And then Dean Ambrose says, okay, don't come to my aid anymore. You're not my friend. I don't trust you. This is no Shield reunion, which only leads me to believe that we're going to get a Shield reunion. That line alone leads me to believe we're getting a Shield reunion. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. We're getting a Shield reunion. Or at least a two-thirds Shield reunion with Ambrose and Rollins. But hey, since all three members of the Shield are already on there, and I'm not even sure I want to see it at this point with the way they're booking Roman. And the reason I say I don't want to see it, because, listen, it doesn't make sense to have two guys who are really, well, one guy who's really liked, one guy who's just kind of falling from grace, so to speak, and then another guy who never had the grace to begin with and end up retiring Undertaker and damn near killed Braun Strowman, which I'll get into that. And then, you know, doing all these big things, you know, they're clearly going to bill him as the star of the Shield. They're going to bill Roman Reigns as the star of the Shield, make him lead the Shield. And honestly, I don't know if I want to see that. I don't want to see him as the main guy of the Shield, which I feel like that's what they're going to do with him. And when it was the Shield, it was nobody leading anybody. There was all three on equal ground. They were equally likable. And yeah, now the story is different. That's why I don't want to see a Shield reunion. Now, do I feel like all three can benefit from it? Sure. Sure. Ambrose sure as hell can benefit from it. Rollins sure as hell can benefit from it. Roman, yeah, in terms of fan popularity, he could sure as hell benefit from it, but in certain ways, all three of guys have gone their separate ways. They all have their own characters. Let them be, because honestly, they all need to figure themselves out now. And I mean that for everybody, in terms of certain aspects. Actually, in terms of character aspects. You know, Ambrose needs to figure out what the hell he wants to be. If he wants to be a comedian, fine. But at least find a balance, you know. I want to see at least a little bit of a balance. At least in 2015, when Ambrose was just getting turned on and he just started his character as the Lunatic Fringe, at least he had a balance within his character. At least. You know, he had some comedy skits here and there. Not all of them were great, but sure, he had a balance in there. He also could be a serious character, and now he's just a whack job. He's not crazy, he's just wacky. That's what he needs. He needs, forget an insane asylum, this guy just needs to get a straitjacket and just gets thrown in a loony bin. He's so wacky. Maybe he starts seeing all the cartoon kids on the cereal boxes. Maybe he's talking to his imaginary friends too. With the guy who's Cuckoo for Cuckoo Puffs. That's what he reminds me of. A cereal box character. Tricks are for kids. Cuckoo for Cuckoo Puffs. Whatever the hell else there is nowadays. That's what Ambrose reminds me of now. Roman Reigns. No more of this shade of gray nonsense. Either he's a heel or he's a face. And if he's a heel, stop booking him against other heels. Make the guy a full-fledged heel. None of this crap that, oh, because he's booed, that means he's a heel. No. Make the guy a heel already. If that's what you're going to do. If that's what you're going to consider the guy. None of this crap anymore. I'm sick of this. I'm going to insult your intelligence nonsense of, hey, you boo this guy? Yeah, he's a heel. What does that even mean? People booed John Cena, have been booing John Cena for years now. He has not turned heel since 2004. Sit here and tell me John Cena's a heel. Is John Cena a heel too? Is Randy Orton a heel? I mean, it sure as hell seems like it with the heelish performances he gives. And I don't want to say heelish performances in terms of he acts like a heel. No, he acts like a heel in terms of giving shitty performances. That's what I mean. Now, Seth, I don't have as much problem with. Honestly, I don't. Because at least I can get what Seth is about. You know, he's the anti-authority character. Okay, he's rebellious. He's clearly his own character. He's regained who he was before he signed. He's the guy who he was before he signed with the authority, you know. And from what I understand, he's probably the guy who he was before the Shield, you know. So maybe he's that kind of character, what we saw in NXT, that really cool rocker NXT guy, but in a more evolved form, so to speak. So Seth Rollins, I don't have too much to complain about here. However, I do think we could see a little bit of tweaking, a little more establishment with Seth Rollins. However, these two nut jobs over here, Mr. Identity Crisis and Cuckoo for Cuckoo Puffs over here, they need to figure their shit out a little bit more. So anyway, Seth Rollins comes out, he saves Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose says, there's no Shield reunion, all that stuff. And all I know is Miz versus Ambrose will be over momentarily.
All right, so what's going on, guys? Thank you for watching that clip. This was certainly a good podcast. And I'm sure you as a viewer wants to see the whole thing. So if you're wondering where you can catch this whole thing, depending on where you're watching this video from, well, there will be a link provided in the description below. And I'm telling you right now, it is definitely not a must-miss podcast. Check it out. And also, if you're wondering where to get this music that is being played in the background, that is the AWSM Medium guy. He is on YouTube. I will provide a link in the description below so you can check out his channel and all of his stuff. He also provided the music for my intro, which is why I give credit to him during the beginning of my podcast. And besides that, you know, be sure to check him out. Tell him I said hi, and hopefully he can get that Becky Lynch track finished by now. I've been waiting on that for a little while. But in all seriousness, be sure to check out the full version in the link in the description below. Again, thank you for watching this little clip, and good night, guys.